You're listening to Compact Weekly, powered by the Midwest Compact Touring Series. All the compact racing news in one spot. With your hosts, Drew Jack and Woody. Welcome to another week of Compact Racing News. I'm on the line with Melinda Russell. She's one of our staples here on the show. Melinda just finished her first radio show of her own. Welcome, Melinda.
Thank you, Woody. I think it went well, and I appreciate your help with that. I couldn't have done it without you.
Not a problem. Like I said, we want to help you out in any way you can. You've helped us out so much. Drew, he may visit us. He may not. He's not feeling up to 100%. So
I saw that. Yeah.
Yep. So we actually are going to have a pretty good show today. excuse me there. We have a guest, a female driver. Why don't you tell us a little bit about her before she calls in?
Well, her name is Olivia Horton, and she races at the South Bend Motor Speedway. And I have not met her personally, but I have seen her because when I was at the South Bend Motor Speedway banquet, she received quite a number of awards. And so I put a thing on Facebook, say, hey, I'm looking to interview somebody, and I ran across her name, and it was familiar to me because I remember hearing it several times, and she was called up on stage that night. So I reached out to her to see if she'd be interested in being on the show, and she said yes, she would. So we're going to learn together more about Olivia and how she started her racing career and what she's doing.
Great. Excuse me there. And then we're going to have on Gary Howe, the owner promoter of Kalamazoo Speedway. Lots of changes going on at Kalamazoo this year, and Gary will bring us up to speed on that. Plus, we have our first race of the year, 51 days away. We're going to have a great, huge event. Oh, my gosh, I can't believe we have over 40 cars registered right now for
that
event.
That's exciting.
And then at 9 o'clock, we're going to have a tech corner. You can call in for anybody wants to call in, can call in and ask technical advice. If you'd like to call in during that time, the number is 646-668-8238, and I'll put that number out again later. So how was your week, Melinda?
Oh, my gosh. I have been busy. I have my magazine all done except for one lady who is having difficulty getting the pictures to me that I need, and so I gave her till tomorrow, and I said, if you can't get them to me, I'll just take your story out this month, and we'll put you in next month, and otherwise it's ready to go, so watch for that. It's going to be coming out, what is today, Wednesday? It'll be coming out at least by Friday, if not sooner, so I'm excited about that. That's the March issue. I've got some really cool guests that I'm starting to line up for this show and also my show that is the hour right before this show. I'm not going to say who they are yet. I want to hold that back and get my list together, but some exciting things happening there. You guys created a monster when you invited me to be on your show, and I'm loving it because I love stories, and that's what I'm hearing from these people. So, and I'm going to the Land of the Sun next Wednesday, which is Arizona, for those of you that do not know, to visit my daughters. But I will be broadcasting from there, and I will make sure I tell you how warm it is while I'm there. How's that?
Well, you're just going to tease us, aren't you?
Yeah,
these aren't the only radio shows you're doing. I saw that you're also on another radio show also.
You know, it's funny. That was the first one that reached out to me, actually. On Facebook, a gentleman from New York, his name is Richard White, he produces the Dirt Track Racing Network, and it's online shows just like this. He has a few shows that they do during the week, and he reached out and said, we don't have any women or women-focused presence on our network. Would you be interested in doing a show for us? And so it took us a few weeks to get that all figured out and what we were going to do and when and everything. And so on Tuesday nights, from 7 to 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, I'm doing a radio show for him all about girls in dirt track racing. So the name of that show is Dirty Girls, a racing show about women in dirt track racing. And so that's kind of fun. We had our we've had two shows now. The first week we interviewed the people from Beckley Motorsports Park in West Virginia. It was a great interview. And then we had another one last night. And so we're working on dirt track racing ladies. So if there's anybody out there that fits that bill, get a hold of me on Facebook and we'll get you scheduled for the radio.
You are one busy lady and the race season hasn't even started.
I know. My feed, my Facebook feed, I can't even keep up with it. I just go and mark them all as read because I can't even begin to read them all. It's crazy.
Yep.
Crazy
and then you
good.
Also have your, it's great, and I love that the business has taken off like this. I mean, I am so proud of what you're doing, but also I see that next year you're going to have a big office space with 5 or 6 employees. It might be a way you keep going.
Yeah. My daughter in Arizona actually works with me on this some. She hasn't worked with me a lot on anything except a magazine at this point, but she works as a personal assistant, and I think I'm going to have to hire her to be mine instead because, wow, it's getting crazy, it is, but I love it.
And then you also have another business that you're doing, Send Out Cards. Why don't you talk a little bit about Send Out Cards?
Okay. Yeah, I've been a distributor for Send Out Cards for 10 years now. Send Out Cards is a web-based greeting card and gifting business that I have. I have a lot of customers. In fact, our other guest tonight, Gary Howe, Kalamazoo Speedway, was my first racetrack customer, and he uses it very effectively, and he works with you, Woody, because you're the photographer. We send cards to the winners each week from his track. Sometimes they get brownies, sometimes they don't, just depends. And it has really done well, I think, to improve relationships between a track owner and drivers and just gives the track that little extra something that they're doing for their drivers to give back. It's not expensive for him to do it. It takes a little bit of time. But other than that, I mean, you know, you're talking about 5 cards a week. South Bend Motor Speedway also does it. And I'm looking to expand that to other racetracks primarily because racetracks need to give back, not just the purse money, but something that's tangible that they can keep. Those cards with pictures of those people in the winner's circle on those cards, they're never going to throw them away. They're going to keep them forever. And so that's a bit of history that can be handed down to their family. So I'm proud of Gary for taking the leap to do that with me to get us started. And so anybody that's interested in knowing more about how to use Send Out Cards for their race team or their business, it's a great business tool. They can get a hold of me on Facebook and I'm happy to talk to them about it.
It's a great marketing tool, and those drivers that are out there right now looking for sponsors, and one of the things that you could offer them is these cards. So you can send out to them when you win every week or you win a heat.
Right.
Or just to say thank you. This is something extra. They make the sponsors love this stuff. Well, it looks like our caller is on the line.
Okay.
So we're excited to see that. Why don't you go ahead and introduce her again?
Okay, Olivia, can you hear us all right?
Yeah.
All right, good. Your voice is good and strong. So this is Olivia Horton. Yeah. And Olivia, we have never met officially, although like I said earlier, I do know who you are. I saw you receive several awards when I was at the banquet. So I'm going to just go through some questions and we're going to get to know you better and let you tell our listeners a little bit more about yourself and your racing career. So why don't we start with tell us like where you race, where you live, and maybe, you know, a little bit about yourself and your family.
Well, I'm Olivia Horton. I'm 20 years old. I live in South Bend, Indiana. My home track is South Bend Motor Speedway, and I started racing at 16.
Okay, and what kind of a car did you start in?
I started in a 93 Saturn, so a front-wheel drive, a 4-cylinder.
And what are you driving now, the same car or something different?
I'm in a 97 Eagle Talon, still a 4-cylinder, but instead of the automatic, it's a manual, and
Ooh.
It's a little bit quicker.
Okay, awesome. So you, yeah, I knew you raced at South Bend Boner Speedway, another one of my favorite places to go. So since I know you won some awards, why don't you tell us a little bit about that? What awards did you receive at the banquet a few weeks ago?
I got perfect attendance, fourth place in points, and most improved driver for the Hornet class.
That's amazing. So 20 years old, you've been racing since you were 16. So you're a veteran, really, at this point. You've been around the track a while. Who got you started in racing? What is your family in it, or who gave you the interest?
Well, my uncle got my dad into it way back when. My dad was at South Bend. 2001, he won track champion. And then they just got me into it. And I just have a bunch of uncles and cousins, and my dad's in it, and my stepmom's going to start racing here soon, and my aunts, and it's just a lot of my family's in it.
Oh, it sounds like it. So have you had to race against anybody that's in your family?
I've had to race against my dad and my uncle, and they do not let up. They do not care that I'm on the track.
Of course not. They would hate to see that you beat them, so... You've got to get a little stronger there and a little faster. You got to show those men who's boss.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you've got a lot of family racing. So is that, do you all just help each other with your car, or who else do you have that helps with your car?
Basically, we all help each other. We bring just my little group brings about 10 to maybe 12 cars every week.
Wow. Wow, that's a lot. That you've got, you're taking up the whole pit area almost. Yeah.
A lot.
That's,
yeah,
which,
it's a lot.
Go ahead.
Which
no,
car
I think there
do you
was,
drive?
There's Woody. He wants to ask you a question.
Okay.
Sorry. I'm going through the pictures that I shot last year. I made it to one event. Which car do you actually drive? Are you driving the 11 Junior car, the green one?
Yes, I'm the 11 Junior, and then my dad's the blue 11.
Okay.
Okay.
Got,
so the junior comes because you're the daughter. Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. So maybe Woody can put some pictures up on our site, on the Midwest Compact site, of you with your car. That would be cool. So you all help each other. What's been your proudest moment in your racing career?
Well, my proudest moment, I actually have a few.
Okay.
Well, my first proudest moment was when I got my Powder Puff win at Mottville. I was, like, ecstatic. And then that's when I started racing with the boys. Shortly, like, a week after that was the start of South Bend's year in 2015. So I started racing with the boys. And then that year, I got a feature win at Mottville.
Nice.
I was excited about that one. And then the most improved driver that I just recently got was probably my proudest moment, because I really didn't think I was going to win that award. So.
And so that was a surprise.
Yeah, it really was.
Yeah, that's nice, because you know where you land in the points, so that's no surprise.
Hello,
and you knew you had perfect attendance, so that was no surprise. So getting that award was a nice thing to take home that night. That was a nice banquet they had. So tell me, do you have any marketing partners or people that you want to share or say a shout out to?
If you're not receiving a well, my main one is Gavin Labs Racing. It's a big between my family's team. And then there's Hazley Motorsports, which is basically another one of my family's teams.
Mm-hmm.
And then to the biggest people, when I totaled my Saturn, I thought I was not going to race this past year, and my friend Allie, she stepped out of the car, and
hey, Paul,
her dad basically gave me their car. Like,
called me this morning,
me.
And I wasn't able to take
and
the call.
He
I am on the
is
phone
my biggest
on
sponsor,
and
that's
RMB
Car Company.
But my
okay, well, that was super nice. Somebody
hand
you a car. That doesn't happen
very
often.
What our options are at this point.
Yeah,
not
that's very
that's
cool.
going on.
Very
to
cool.
Refinance,
so,
we have to get our payment
tell
lowered.
Me, what
payment
is it that you enjoy
the
most
the
about
10,
racing?
12 years we've lived here, almost $500
basically,
a month.
Basically, the people at the track,
just a ridiculous
we're
amount.
All one big happy family.
And so we need to get our payment
we need
lowered
something.
Back down
they,
to where
they're
we can
usually there to help
it.
Us.
Otherwise, we're going to have to do something different, sell
fun.
Our house or something
like,
drastic.
The first time I
so
ever went out on the track,
really
I just got a
some
rush,
options
and, I knew, like,
and some help
to
you could give us.
Yeah, that's right here.
269-760-1111.
That's great. And so you're working
again,
on your car, I assume.
Russell,
is your car ready to go, or where are
you
in the process there?
My car basically went in the garage last year with a few minor things, so it's not going to come out until probably like a week before. Because, like I said, we have a bunch of other cars we're trying to focus on that's nowhere near done. So, I mean, if mine got to sit a little bit longer, it's just a few minor things.
Okay. So what other kind of cars race in your family? Do you have in all divisions? You have all different kinds?
Mostly front-wheel drive, your Hornets. And then my uncle has a late model, I believe he has. It's either
okay.
a late model or a sportsman, but I think he's the only one that's not a front-wheel drive.
Okay. All right.
But,
so now Woody, would she be the right kind of car, I think, for your Midwest Compact Series?
Well, yeah. we
yeah.
ran down there. We actually do run a race down there with them.
Okay.
And she's welcome to join us. She's welcome to come up. I don't know if you've heard about some of the promotions we're doing. But we have a race on the 27th of April and another one on the 28th, Kalamazoo Speedway on the 27th and Berlin Speedway on the 28th. They both pay $1,000 to win, and if you could be the first woman for the 2018 race season to win an A main, you get an extra $1,000. So it's something you may want to look into. Yeah.
Might have to.
Make some serious money.
Right.
I had a reservation for Melinda
yeah.
Russell. R-U-S-S-S-S-L-L.
So you may
want to
get that car out of the garage.
For the 19th.
And come to Kalamazoo the end of April and then the
and
next night at Berlin.
Cancel. I was coming for the
so,
NASCAR race. And
that's a pretty big deal.
So
Woody got his checkbook out and said he'd pay $1,000, if I'm correct, to the first
yep.
woman
I'm
to
sorry,
win
what?
An A main in the Midwest Compact Series. So my granddaughter is going
to
be racing there, and
a
couple
calendar,
of her friends from the former quarter midget track. There's
maybe?
Quite a few women
Friday,
already
let's
registered.
See.
So get on that website, Olivia, and get your aunt,
hang
your
on,
mom, and all of you guys
you
come up and visit us in Kalamazoo because that's going to
so
be a lot
second.
Of fun. Having that much
yeah,
money
I was coming
line.
The 17th
yeah.
and checking out the
so
20th.
So check that out. We'd love to see you on the roster.
Do you
roster.
Want the confirmation number?
So you told me you raced against
you
your dad.
It. Yes.
Is there anyone
that's
else
correct.
That you like to race against or you would like to
yes,
race
please.
Against?
Unfortunately, they're not going to be
female,
racing.
I
so
racing
I'll come and stay with you whenever we
so
get
well.
Back to racing.
Her name's Maggie McIntyre.
All right.
She's
thank
one
you so much.
Of my
stay
favorite
safe.
Drivers I can race with.
Mm-hmm.
I know bye. If me and her is next to each other, we won't even touch each other.
Okay. Well, that's some good clean racing for a change, right?
Yeah.
That's great. So I know South Bend has a lot of girls and women that race.
Yes.
Just give me some idea. Just take a guess. How many women do you think race at South Bend right now? Or last year?
All together, I think last year, maybe close to about 15, I would say.
Wow. Yeah, that's
in the
great.
Hornets, in the Hornets alone, I think there was like 12.
Ooh, okay. All right. So Laura Alwine, I think you know who she is.
Yes.
And I think your picture, you were in a picture with her in our magazine when we did a story on her. So that many girls at that track, why do you think racing is a good sport for girls to get involved in?
That's a hard question. I think a lot of the girls that do it, they either grew up around it or their spouse or boyfriend does it and they actually got their girl in the car. And, like, I think it's a good sport because it's you get the adrenaline and then girls shouldn't be afraid to race with boys.
Right.
Like, we trade some paint, but that shows the boys we're not scared to rough some paint and beat and bang, you know.
Right, and you're not going to back down from them.
No.
Right.
Not at all.
Yeah. So, you're 20 years old. You must work or go to school. What do your friends think about you racing?
Well, most of my friends race with me, so.
So,
I
you
think
all think the same
have...
about each other?
Yeah, we do.
Yeah. Yeah. That's unusual. You know, a lot of girls play volleyball with their friends or basketball or softball. But I have to say you're probably the first girl that's answered that question that most of your friends also race. So that, to me, that's very cool. So it's the off season. Go ahead.
Yeah. I said basically my friends are the ones I race with in Hornets. Like, I don't hang out with anybody else. Like, the off season, you know, it's a little by myself. But during the race season, we're always right there next to each other when we're not in the cars talking to each other.
Okay. All right. So that was one of my questions was going to be, so it's the off season. You didn't have to work on your car very much. What do you do during the off season? How do you entertain yourself?
Literally just go to work, and then I guess when my dad or one of them has a car to be built, I just go out there and try to help them with theirs as much as I can without getting in the way.
Yeah, okay. So you're out of school. You work, you told me. So what is your long-term goal for racing? Do you want to – are you happy where you are? Do you want to move up to some other kind of a car? What are your thoughts about that?
Well, I want to, like, hopefully next year I want to move up to front wheels, which is the more outlawed class, and then hopefully in the future go even up higher than that. But I, my goal for hopefully this year is hopefully championship.
Okay.
Because I really want that champion.
Yeah, that's a good goal to have. And you were at every race last year, so that's a good start.
I actually got perfect attendance the past 3 years. So my 3 years I've raced, I've got perfect attendance.
Whoa, that's pretty amazing. So you've got a good shot at getting that championship. I'm going to be cheering you on since I've heard that that's your goal.
Yeah, my rookie year, I got 5th place in points, and then last year I had a bad year and got 14th in points, and then this year I got 4th in points.
Okay, so 4th is good. Now you've only got 3 spots more to go up, and you're going to have that.
Yeah.
Awesome. So how do the men treat you at the track in South Bend? We're going to put those guys on the spot.
Some of the guys think that since I'm a girl, I shouldn't be out there and that I should back down and everything. But I don't try to back down. Obviously, if there's, like, a wreck or something, I'm going to get out of the gas. But if they're, like, battling me door to door, I'm not going to get out of the gas just because I'm a girl.
Right. Right. Good for you. Hold your own. That's great. Woody, do you have any questions for Olivia?
I always ask the same question, and
go ahead.
What is your proudest moment in racing?
I think my proudest moment is just within my 3 years, I've got 2 top 5s in points. Honestly,
that's a good one.
That's
you're going to have a lot more. I mean, you're young. You got a good family behind you. So do you plan on staying with the 4-cylinders or do you want to move up to a late model, say, in the next 4, 5, 6 years?
I don't think I'll go up that high. I kind of like the 4 and 6-cylinders. They're fun.
That's like I said, every time I go down to South Bend, I have a blast. I'm good friends with the photographer, Jay Frett, down there.
Mm-hmm.
He's very open to having us out there. I have a blast out there, fun little track. You guys have some great car counts. Food is excellent out there. So I love going down to South Bend. I try to make it at least once a year. Kind of hard with my busy schedule. So I know that I'll be looking for you next time I go down.
Yeah,
okay.
I will too. My goal is to try to meet all the women that I've interviewed in person. And so I've got a little notepad, and I'm keeping track of their names and where they are. So when summer comes, I'm probably going to be on the road and busy too, but I'll be down to see you as well. Is there anything else that we didn't ask you about or that you would like to share with us about either yourself or your racing career or the track where you race? Just kind of a wrap it up kind of question.
I don't think so.
Okay.
That's about it.
Okay. All right. Well, you know what, Olivia, I'm glad that we connected on Facebook and that you were willing to come and be on the radio with us. If you know a lot of other girls at South Bend, pass the word that we're looking for girls to interview, and we'd love to have their names and pass those on to us. And I will be down to see you this summer and meet you in person and cheer you on. And your number is the what, junior, 11?
11 junior.
11 junior, okay. What color are you going to be?
I'm going with my bright green that I ran last year, so you're not going to miss the car.
Okay,
it's
great.
Bright green, and then I think I'm going to do pink camo numbers, so I don't think you can miss my car at all.
Oh, so you've got the green and pink. Those are the logo colors of my International Women's Motorsports Association, so I'm going to have to send you a couple of decals to put on your car. How's that?
That's fine.
Okay. All right. Sounds good. Woody, any final thoughts for Olivia?
Hello, this
I just
is want Amanda.
To thank her for being part of the show.
Olivia,
I want to hopefully that you have
hi.
Great success for 2018. You
yeah.
and your whole race team. And
I'm good. How are you?
Staff and drivers down
well,
at South Bend Motor Speedway.
Well,
great family down there.
I
so.
Received your voice.
So thank you
thank
for being
you.
Part of the show.
Thank you, Olivia.
All right. We'll let you go,
bye.
Olivia. You have a great evening. Bye-bye.
Okay, you too.
All right, bye-bye.
So...
Well, that was a great interview. She's got good goals set this year. They've got
yeah.
a good class of four cylinders
yeah.
down there. And like
mm-hmm.
I said, there's some great racing down there at South Bend.
Yeah, and I knew they had
yeah,
a lot
but it
of
wasn't
girls
with
that were
Mr.
racing.
Cooper.
I'll bet they'll have more this
my,
year than they're
my,
expecting because
no,
it sounds
yeah.
to me like
yeah,
the women are coming out of the
ago,
woods and getting their cars ready to go, and they're going to
okay.
compete
yeah.
with those
here's
men, you know, one car at
oh,
a time. So I'm excited about it.
We've got a lot
okay.
of women registering right now. I talked to Drew the other day, and
okay.
I don't know quite the number yet. He's supposed to get it
yeah.
for me, but I know
that's
we're over
okay.
40 drivers registered for Kalamazoo race.
Mm-hmm.
And if I remember right, I think 12 of them are females.
I think so. Yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna
and you may have
a
two or three more now from South Bend, so that'd be great.
Yes. And like I said, we're looking at
oh, I didn't know that.
Easily having over 50 cars.
I didn't realize
down
that.
Do
yeah.
from April 27th.
Yeah.
We are
okay.
going to be probably A, B, and C
oh, it's
if
been
we keep
at least
this
that.
Up at this rate.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So one of the things we're looking for, and anybody out there in the radio world know about a business.